Hi, Warren.
Yeah.
Hi, Warren. This is the discussion group, the Montreal branch. We're wishing you many happy returns of retiring from our leadership.
I have known Warren Allmand for many years as a fellow member of the WFMC board. My enduring impression of him is that despite his distinguished career and illustrious credentials, he has retained a modest and unpretentious demeanor. His wealth of knowledge and experience has always been implicit and offered to our deliberations with great respect for the views of others.
On hearing of your retirement, my mind flits back over the decades to my first contact with you at a World Federalist Montreal branch meeting in the 1960s. It was a meeting where you were proposing a resolution banning US nuclear weapons in Canada. The years pass, and another highlight is a World Federalist AGM at Loyola College, Montreal, where you spoke as Member of Parliament for NDG, your riding. Sometime in that decade, the Parliamentary Association of World Federalists was formed in Ottawa, with your input. This became an international organization of legislators, later known as Parliamentarians Global Action. Four of the first five presidents were Canadian MPs, including you. These are just a few scintillas that spring to mind in your dedication and contribution in over half a century for a governed world of peace, economic and social justice.
I first met you in your office in Parliament when you were Solicitor General of Canada in the 1970s, and I was a Vietnam War resistor and a newly landed immigrant to Canada. I remember being incredulous and feeling empowered by your firm support for allowing American military deserters to apply inside Canada for permanent resident status. This was a powerful gesture and an important moment in the struggle against the American hubris of the time.
Hi, Warren. It's Rob, and this is just to thank you for all the great work you've done with the World Federalists from the very beginning, and I know you've been a World Federalist for decades, but from perspective of somebody who was on the board with you over the last number of years, I must say that I've always enjoyed working with you and been a big admirer of all the work you've done on many issues, including Indigenous issues and development and disarmament and many other areas.
All right. Hello, Warren and colleagues from the World Federalists. This is John Trent, chair of the board, those meetings that Warren used to love to co-chair with me. And I'm here simply to say, Warren, you have taught us over 12 years of your presidency with the World Federalists how important it is to pay attention to detail and to see the importance of legal documents. I mean, little things like constitutions. But more importantly, of course, it was your great depth of humanism, your attention to the questions of human rights and Aboriginal rights that showed us that our agenda was on the right track.
Salute, Warren Allmand. A great parliamentarian, a great World Federalist, a great humanitarian. I first met Warren back in the 1970s when we were both in Parliament together, and he taught me a lot of things about how Parliament should work and indeed how Parliament ought to work for the world, for world peace, for justice, for disarmament, for human rights, for the environment.
And I would like to say that it is an honor to be taking part in this tribute to Warren Allmand. I've known Warren for over 30 years. In 1983, I was very fortunate to be hired by him to be his executive assistant on Parliament Hill. I worked for Warren for 10 years. He was my boss, my mentor, and he is my friend. Speaking on behalf of former staff from his ministerial and parliamentary offices, I would like to say that working for Warren was an honor. His dedication and commitment to issues that mean so much to the fabric of our nation, of Canada, issues like gun control, the abolition of capital punishment, nuclear disarmament, Aboriginal rights. There's so many, the list just goes on and on. And his dedication and commitment to these issues and others that go to the heart of Canadian values.
World Federalist Movement. On behalf of the World Federalist Movement, we wish to send our great congratulations and thanks to Warren Allmand, who has served as the national president of WFM Canada for the last 12 years. Warren and my path overlap several decades, since he was one of the leaders of the WFM parliamentary supporters, establishing a global NGO for the last 30 years known as the Parliamentarians for Global Action, but was originally Parliamentarians for World Order. Warren has been a strong supporter of WFM's campaign for a UN Parliamentary Assembly, a UN reform initiative WFM has promoted since 1948. With our very successful global UN Parliamentary Assembly campaign today, one that emerged from WFM Canada. We also worked with Warren when he led one of the best human rights NGOs in Canada 15 years ago. I know our president, Lloyd Axworthy, joins me in praising Warren as a great parliamentarian and a great world federalist.
Exemplary and indefatigable. Those two words sum up much of my impressions of you, Warren. Modest in stature, but a giant when it comes to achievements, you have left a significant impact at the local, national, and international levels. Every time I'm at a meeting or gathering with you, Warren, I watch as you fiddle with your gold ring. On several occasions, you nearly lost it for good. If you remember, we solved that problem quickly during one of our Montreal branch coffee and discussion sessions. You owe me one.
When I first became an activist with the World Federalists back in the early 1980s, I remember being impressed that your name was on our stationery. Someone with the credibility and gravitas of a federal cabinet minister endorsing and supporting the work of world federalism. That meant something. I think it gave me a bit more courage in my views and in the rightness of the cause. And I'm sure it took some courage on your part to be so openly identified with the work of an organization like the World Federalist Movement and with its goals, because there's always the potential of a political cost to coming out as an idealist in a world of political hard-ass and cynical realism.
I hung out with Warren a lot at the United Nations, and during that time, I was very impressed with how Warren treated everyone equally. Warren never got caught up in the hierarchies of the UN, whether he was dealing with heads of state or grassroots activists. He treated everyone as equally deserving of his respect. I think this really reflects Warren's personal beliefs. Warren was motivated by a genuine belief in people's goodwill. We need more people like Warren in the political sphere, people who embody a devotion to civic service and to serving the community.
From the beginning in 2007, WFM Canada has been an important stakeholder in the campaign for a UN Parliamentary Assembly. There is a long history of support in Canada that reaches back to the late 1980s and early 1990s. In 1993, for example, the House of Commons Committee on External Affairs and International Trade recommended that Canada should endorse a UNPA. As a member and then later as President of Parliamentarians for Global Action, Warren already worked actively to get parliamentarians more involved in the UN and global governance. I would like to take the opportunity to thank Warren and the whole team of WFM Canada, especially Fergus Watt, for their unabated commitment to this cause and our most productive and enjoyable collaboration.
Our work has, I dare say, made some advances on some of those files during those years, and some of them were difficult years. But my own personal acquaintance with Warren goes back much further, to the 1980s, when I first began working with the World Federalists, and Warren was one of the key go-to parliamentarians for anyone working on peace and human rights and disarmament causes. Through all of this, Warren has of course remained a touchstone of common sense and decency and integrity. He's widely regarded as one of Canada's great human rights experts, and we've really benefited greatly from his leadership in the World Federalists. We don't often take the time to thank those of us who have made significant contributions to the cause, and so Warren, I hope you won't mind that some of us have ganged up on you with the effort to generate this small video tribute on the occasion of the 2016 annual meeting.
I'm working with Warren right now with the National Archives of Canada on information that he left with the archives when he ceased to be a parliamentarian. The archives have over 155 boxes that contain his notes as a minister, his notes as a member of parliament, critical issues, employment, immigration, gun control, capital punishment, I've mentioned these before. And of those 158 boxes, 138 of them are deemed historical by the Canadian Archives. That is simply outstanding. It is a contribution to our national identity and to our country. Warren, thank you.
I'm very grateful for the time we worked together. My time with Warren was brief, but like many people, the impact he had on me is long-lasting.
I want to say that it's been an honor to have worked with you over the years, and a pleasure, and I'm profoundly grateful to you, Warren, for all that you've done in the great millennial cause of world federalism and building the institutional scaffolding of one world.
Warren, right now, you are dealing with a more personal challenge that involves health issues. Just know that I and so many other World Federalists are on your team as you stick handle the medical appointments and treatments that lie ahead. Your first priority, focus on getting better. Best regards.
Our hopes that the human race will make peace with each other, with the rest of life on Earth, with our planet, is a hope in the Warren Allmands of the world, that love and intelligence will trump hatred and stupidity. Thank you, Warren.
Warren was way ahead of his time, and I'm really glad to have this moment just to say thanks, Warren.
What can I say, Warren? We're going to miss your presidency terribly.
Thanks very much. I've really enjoyed all the time we've had together, and good luck for future endeavors, and good health. Bye for now.
Conclusion, I say bravo, Warren, and I look forward to reading your fascinating memoirs. Thanks, and all the best, Bill Hartzell.
So my thanks, Warren. A postscript. You will remember Bill Sheehan, the first president of the World Federalists of Canada. He had this T-shirt made at a WAF Congress in Tokyo in the 1960s.
After so many years of unselfish service. He will be sorely missed. I wish him only the best for the coming years.
Hi, Warren.